I love driving down Jayhawk Boulevard, getting that sense of history, that sense of connectedness with our legacy, and now the opportunity to think beyond that as I'm having the opportunity to have conversations about what the future is like, what it could be like for KU, specifically in the area of facilities and its development. It's exciting to think about.
Dr. Martin, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, thank you. It's great to be here and appreciate the opportunity.
Yes, well, welcome back to
KU.
I hear you are a fifth generation Kansan and you may have 1 to 3 degrees from our university.
I do. Yes, a fifth generation Kansan. My family came in 1857, four years before Kansas became a state. Certainly as I was looking at, you know, graduate programs after undergrad, there was only one place I wanted to go, and only certain degrees that I wanted to pursue.
Oh, of course.
And so I began with a law degree and then added in the joint program an MBA. And then knew that my path would be in higher education. And so came back then after a couple of years, graduated from those first two programs and completed a Doctor of Education in the School of Education here.
So with you coming back to the Hill, maybe what has been the most exciting aspects of your presidency role for you?
For me, the best thing is coming back and realizing that I am an individual that has the opportunity to contribute to a university that gave me so much. I mean, I really owe my career, my path, and my really my professional experience to the University of Kansas.
Could you share with us why endowments are important and why are they important for the success of a university, a research-based institution like KU?
Right. Yeah, you know, philanthropy, you know, we were established in 1891. And so we were the nation's first endowment associated with a public university. So the endowment has had the opportunity to work with philanthropic partners to flow through to the university $3.6
billion
since that time.
$3.6
billion? Since 1891. And we still maintain a corpus of nearly $3 billion. So those funds provide a sustaining level of support for the university that simply can't be accommodated with just the institutional funds that it receives either through tuition or the other areas in which they derive revenue, but then from the state of Kansas as well. We obviously know there's pressures on state budgets. So this is an opportunity for us to sustain the level of excellence that we want to pursue, to always do what we can to provide opportunities for students to pursue their path, their future, their career, to have access to facilities, to the latest tools and technologies, to recruit faculty members, to provide the level of education that we believe is a level of excellence that we want to pursue at the university.
From your experience, what do you see changes or shifts in the area that you serve in, impacting fundraising and the work that endowments doing currently?
Yeah, I do think the nature of higher education continues to evolve and change, and we see that here certainly at a flagship university associated with the state. There are various aspects of the university that we want to sustain, that we want to ensure exist in the future for the level and type of education that we want to offer. Our mission is to partner with individuals, provide philanthropic support to build a greater University of Kansas. And just the culture of giving continues to evolve and change, and different generations have different perspectives of how they want to give, why they give, what motivates them to give, and how they want to ensure that their giving is making a difference.
You talk about this culture of giving.
Mm-hmm.
We have One Day, One KU.
That's right.
Coming up
Yep.
very soon. For those that might be new to this this initiative that we
Yep.
have, could you share a little bit more about what that is and what are some things that's going to be happening this year with One Day, One KU?
Yep.
How can people get involved,
and
why that's important?
Yeah, there's a number of ways in which you can get involved that don't even include, giving or supporting it financially. You can be an ambassador. You can facilitate giving. That's one of the things that we talk about with individuals that have different levels of capacity and ability to give. they can participate and contribute and volunteer in a way in which they can engage their own network of individuals in terms of communicating what these opportunities are. You could also maybe step up and provide a challenge grant to encourage others to give, and that's one way to extend the impact of their gift if they can see it being multiplied through a challenge gift opportunity. We do have gifts that range in this program from $5 to several hundred thousand. It's not necessarily about the money, but it's a vote. It's a vote of support, of affirmation for what KU means, to individuals, what it means to this community, what it means to the state of Kansas, the opportunity that it provides, and the more individuals that we can get involved in terms of facilitating our mission, and then for them to see the impact of their giving, I think it can only bode well for our future.
I have to ask you a very fun question that I ask every single Jayhawk that gets in this car. So, Dr. Martin, if you could sum up your Jayhawk experience, right? It sounds like a very positive one.
Yep.
You could sum it up in one song. What song would describe your Jayhawk experience and why?
What song? Well, the first song that popped in my mind, not necessarily a current song, but one certainly associated with Kansas, Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
The Rainbow!
As I think about that song, to me it conveys hope, optimism, the opportunity to think about the future in different ways, to contribute to, in some way, brightening the future in a way that provides light and hope and an opportunity to help others find success. I think that's what would sum up my experience at the University of Kansas for what it offered me in terms of my own career as I thought about my future. But I think what the endowment can offer for the university in terms of thinking about its future success and the ways in which we can contribute to that.
I look forward to getting involved myself. Get involved, Jayhawks, and rock chop.
Rock chop.
That's it.